The hashtag MeToo movement is marching on. And as you may have heard, another of our public media colleagues has been accused of sexual misconduct. Last night, PBS announced it was indefinitely suspending distribution of the show Tabitha Smiley after an outside investigation, quote, uncovered multiple credible allegations of conduct that is inconsistent with the values and standards of PBS. But Smiley did not go quietly into that night. He took to Facebook to express his shock at the announcement.
I have the utmost respect for all women. And I certainly celebrate the courage of those women who've come forth of late to share their own truth. But let me also assure you that I have never groped, inappropriately exposed myself, or coerced any colleague in the workplace ever in my 30-year career. It is clear that this has gone too far, and I, for one, intend to fight back.
PBS executives are standing by their investigation. And if you've watched this show at all over the past couple of months, you know our default position is that the women who make these accusations are to be believed. But if you are wrongly accused, is there any way to fight back? Joining me to discuss our retired federal judge and Harvard Law School professor Nancy Gertner. Nice to see you.
Nice to be here.
Former Attorney General, now partner at Foley Hoag, Martha Coakley.
Hi,
you
Jim.
Too. And former Globe reporter, now executive vice president of the PR firm InkHouse, Tina Cassidy. Good to see you too. Is it safe to say that in the post-Weinstein era, in, as relates to sexual harassment, if you're a man accused, you were guilty until proven innocent? Is that not a fair statement of where we are today? You're nervously nodding your head yes. How about the two of you?
I think that's right. I mean, I think it's right because this is about naming and shaming. This is about public exposure of men who are uniquely vulnerable to public exposure. And you're taking it out of the context of any lawsuit, out of the context of court. So it's, you know, that's the problem.
You seem to be the holdout. I don't see a nodding from you.
The question is, are the procedures in place in all of these institutions that know this behavior is wrong, that presumably have HR and other places to investigate them, are they moving too quickly? And that would have to be case by case.
But when we've broached this topic indirectly on the radio, Marjorie Egan and I can't tell you how many people have said, I'm perfectly fine with this guilty until proven innocent. We've lived through a century where women,
yes,
innocent women,
right,
were guilty or not believed. And I'm paraphrasing, if you have to sacrifice a few innocent men along the way to accomplish something, I'm okay with that.
See, I don't think that's necessary for one thing, and I don't think that's desirable, because I also think if that starts to occur, there will be a pendulum swing and a backlash, and then we'll be back where we
started.
That's
the problem. The problem is the backlash. What would the backlash look like?
What do you mean?
Well,
women will be believed.
Well, somebody. These are powerful men with a lot of resources. There's going to be one woman who's going to be sued for defamation. There will be some.
Duke LaCrosse happened. Everybody remembers Duke LaCrosse and these false rape charges. People in 2017 aren't saying, aha, those three guys were really nailed and look how their lives ruined. No one's mentioning that at all. Everybody's all in 2017, aren't they?
Well, but this is different than this is different than campus issues. This is basically not in a bad way. I mean, to some degree, these are naming and shaming of highly powerful men with lots of resources. So I don't feel as bad for them as the guy on the block who's wrongly accused. These are people who can fight back, but there will be a fighting back, and that's what I worry about.
And the businesses involved know that. They have responsibility to make the decisions as well and as carefully as they can. And people who are wrongfully accused, when it goes public, it's difficult. But if it's not public, they do have ways in which they can.
Yeah, but a lot of these people are saying the first time they heard about this was the day or the moment they were told to clear their crap out of the building.
It isn't like there was a
long hearing process at the end of which some impartial force rendered a verdict and said, you, John Doe, are guilty of sexually assaulting Jane Doe. It's sort of like you're guilty, and then if you choose to use some forum, and you keep saying there's an HR forum, not sure in all these cases there has been, if you choose to use a forum, okay, we'll listen to you. But essentially, other than that, you seem to be out in the world.
No, but then the question has to be, why is that happening then? Because we're not going to blame the women for this. We're going to blame companies that are either acting too hastily or acting on information that we may not know about. You're always going to have, as with Project Veritas we're talking about, you may have people who are punked in this sense. And you always want to be careful that you have the probable cause, you have the information to act the way you do.
Well, you have probable cause if it turns out there's a legal proceeding. The problem is that with none of these cases, even Weinstein, who I think should be wearing an orange jumpsuit for the rest of his life, there is no legal proceeding. So a client comes to you and says, okay, I'm going to be accused tomorrow morning. I didn't do it. Mm-hmm. What do you recommend he do? Where do you recommend? Because, by the way, not everybody can command a camera to come listen to what they have to say. A mid-level executive can't do it.
Right.
What do you tell that person to do?
It's interesting. We've actually gotten those calls.
You have?
Yes, and there's a lot of those calls happening at PR firms across America. I can tell you there's so much more happening than what is actually out there in the news.
In anticipation of being outed or once
yes,
they've been out?
Knowing that things are in motion and bad
okay.
stuff is going to happen.
So what do you tell them to do?
So, I mean, well, for one thing, for those who are not currently clients, we have not taken them on because it's just not something that we need to invest in as a firm. I think that, you know, what seems to be happening is that, you know, companies need to protect themselves as well. It's not just the person who is being outed as a potential
harasser. Would you recommend
harasser.
To them that they publicly stand up and say, I didn't do it, so they've at least
only if they really didn't do
well,
it.
Well, if they believe they didn't
right?
do it. Well, let's get, you know, here's an example of somebody pretty high profile who got a lot of sympathy from some parts of the world who did stand up and say, I didn't do a lot of this stuff. Here's Senator Al Franken.
Some of the allegations against me are simply not true. Others I remember very differently.
He got savaged for this in a lot of liberal right. editorial pages, right. almost. And here's my interpretation of this. My interpretation is, okay, bad enough that you did the underlying things,
right.
but then you essentially stood up, Al Franken, and said the women are lying. And so you almost committed two crimes. I mean,
you know, I'm in pain in this conversation.
Why?
Because on the one hand, you're right. There are decades of women not being believed, and that's what this reaction is to the presumption that women lie.
But you're a due process kind of person. I know it.
But the problem here is that you know, you see people if you are criticizing any of the women for making these accusations, you are blaming the victim, as opposed to making a determination about credibility. Now, that ought to be a determination that isn't made assuming women lie about sex, because that's flat out wrong. But part of the men who are being accused, by the way, like Schumer today, are high-profile
yeah.
you know, politicians as to whom there's going to be a political incentive to
but
accuse.
He was lucky enough. The woman who allegedly is accusing him said she didn't even file the
right.
thing
this
against
was
him.
A well,
the, the Washington Post investigation into Roy Moore, there was at least one person who was sent in by, you know, a Republican.
Veritas, that phony
right. so,
thing.
I mean,
yeah.
So that you're, there is a vulnerability here. There's no question
but
about
you,
it.
But can I get back to your thing? You know, you use the process as it is. I'm not taking sides. I do believe the women in these cases. However, talk to Tavis Smiley. He basically would say the judge and jury decided without even hearing from me, and now you, Martha Coakley, say I should go back in and use the internal HR whatever procedure and trust that they're going to deal with me fairly when they prejudge me?
Well, I think he's going to have some resources at his disposal that other people may not have. But this is not a, you know, a court situation now. We have businesses, companies making decision far, you know, this is behavior that we know is wrong. The people who do it know that's wrong. Many people who deny this behavior probably believe they didn't do anything wrong. I've seen that in years of prosecuting
sure.
child abusers, et cetera, and denial. And so a lot of people will say, I didn't do it. I don't believe I did it. And, you know, this is going to have to sort itself out, obviously. But the good news is that finally, there are some consequences for people. Because all of those people who came out against President Trump thought, okay, we're going to be treated just like Anita Hill. You know, he's got too much power. There's too much at stake. And they've come back again to say, no, we
well,
want
they were
our
right,
stories.
Though, right. Despite right. 16 of them telling their stories.
Right, but I mean, what is also remarkable about this, I mean, these are stories that are actually, we all have heard when we were younger and saw and even experienced. So the notion that it has taken, what, 40 or 50
yeah,
years
that's
to
that's
be.
That's extraordinary.
So it didn't surprise me. The women coming out and talking about this surprised me, but the underlying facts, hell, we're all in that situation.
Let me raise one more thing here. This the proportionality stuff that we've discussed, I'm sure all of you have discussed. So on the same day, you have, I'm not sure this is a great example, you have Tavis Smiley, even though the charges against him sound pretty serious to me, mm-hmm. and you have Russell Simmons accused of three rapes. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the question is, who did what kind of thing? But then here's a clear one. Al Franken, not to excuse what he is accused of doing, and Roy Moore. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so many defenders of Franken said he's being lumped together with a guy who's a child molester.
Right.
And so How do you deal with that reality
There is a continuum here. There clearly is the rape and the child molesting and the public masturbation, and then there's sexual harassment. Sexual harassment can be bad and be debilitating, but certainly not as in the other category.
But they all get named and shamed.
Well, that's right. That's right.
There's no difference in terms of the penalty for the most part. Is that not true?
Right, but part of that is that these are public figures, and they don't want to risk any problem. That's. I'm not sure that would be the case in the ordinary. The ordinary business that people are going to be thrown out with these accusations. This is very much unique to this particular event.
And there is a continuum, but people also are smart enough to know the difference between what Al Franken did and, potentially what Roy Moore did or Russell Simmons, for example. So people are able to make their own judgments. I mean, I guess your point is Al Franken had to give up his seat. He is a victim of the moment in terms of the consequence, if that was more severe than what most people would have thought. But I don't think that he did the wrong thing in stepping down. And I would have definitely advised him to make his statement.
Folks were saying, these heads are rolling everywhere, but in politics. Because everything takes so long, ethics commission. And finally, wrong time, wrong place. But you get 6 complaints, you get 7 complaints. There were a lot more than that.
Yeah, but he stepped down because of Trump. He stepped down because what he's accused of doing is essentially what Trump is accused of doing. And the only way to take the moral high ground was for him to step down.
Well, except he didn't put his hand up any woman's skirt
except
or
be
accused
that.
And
right.
touch her genitalia like Donald Trump is accused of. So I would...
Yeah, picky.
Exactly. By the way, please don't send email. I am on the side of the women. Nice to see you, Judge Gertner.
Thanks, Jim.
Martha Coakley, thank you. Tina, thank you.
Thanks, Jim.
So much. I appreciate it.